Sup guys, Merkeebs here. It's been a bit since my last review, but today, I'm back and we're gonna be checking out and quickly reviewing a highly requested Switch from Akko. Now, before anything else, I just want to make it clear that these Switches were purchased with my own money just for this review. Akko did not send these out and I was not compensated in any way. As always, my opinion about the product is always my own, and this video was not screened prior to publishing. With all that out of the way, now to talk about the Switch. These are the Akko V3 Cream Yellow Switches. These are a 3-pin linear switch manufactured by Akko. These are Akko's third generation of switches. They're sold in a box of 45 for 500 pesos or 2 boxes for 1,000, making each switch around 11 pesos each. For international viewers, that's around $10 for 45 pieces and $20 for 90, making each switch around 22 cents. You can get these switches from local vendors, Rotobox PH and Gosu Gaming Gears. And of course, you could also purchase them directly from Akko on Shopee or directly on their website. The Switch is composed of the following materials. The top housing is made of polycarbonate. The bottom housing is also made of polycarbonate. And the stem is made of palm and has a long pole. It has an operating force of 50 grams and bottoms out at 58 grams. Taking the Switch apart, it doesn't appear to be factory lubed. And now for the typing test. For the typing test, I'll be popping these switches onto my Vega without any mods to get the cleanest sound possible just from the switches themselves. Then for another point of comparison, I'll also throw in a typing test using a Tiger 80 Lite build, just to provide a nice comparison between an Alu board and an ABS plastic board. All the details for the typing tests will be listed on screen, and I'll give my overall thoughts on the Switch right after. Alright, so let's start with how these switches feel. In their stock form, I'd say they're pretty smooth already, which surprised me because the switch itself was really smooth, even if completely dry without any factory lube whatsoever. There was, however, just a teeny smidge of scratch, which I didn't immediately catch after a few typing sessions. Though its teeny tiny scratch is pretty negligible and really easy to ignore. I'd even say these switches are pretty usable stock, if in your experience can't catch the tiny tinge of scratchiness I'm talking about. Though I have to say, lubing just the springs and stems was just enough to really level up the feel of the switch. My preference when lubing certain linears is only lubing the stems and bag lubing the springs. I leave the bottom housing completely alone. After lubing them my way, the switch was even smoother and eliminated every hint of scratch and is comparable even to switches past its price range. Now for the sound. The switches in their stock form are definitely clacky, at least on this Vega build of mine. But to my ear, I do hear a bit of spring ping in a couple of the switches I have. But only if I really stick my ear close to the switch. Not exactly sure why there is a bit of inconsistency with the spring pings on different switches, but after lubing, all the spring ping pretty much went away. And the switches sounded, like their name suggests, creamy. Lubing is definitely something you'll want to consider if you really want to get the most out of these switches. But still, even stock, they can hold their own just fine. Overall, I'm pretty surprised with just how much this switch brings to the table, for how much it's priced. I've personally tried a handful of Akko switches in the past, like the CS Crystals, Jelly Pinks, Jelly Silvers, and CS Air switches. And these don't feel anything like those past iterations. The new third generation mold that Akko is using is really impressive, and I just hope they come out with a 5-pin upgraded variant of these switches in the future. I can definitely see these switches competing directly against other budget players, like the Gateron Pro Milky Yellows and different JWIC variants. So yeah, at 11 pesos or 22 cents a switch, this is really a great bang for your buck switch that I can easily recommend to beginners and more seasoned enthusiasts alike in the Keeb hobby. Definitely looking forward to seeing what else Akko has in store for the switch scene, because they're doing great. Alright, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, please feel free to leave a like, sub if you haven't already, and leave a comment if you have any questions. All relevant links will be in the description down below. Till next time, Merkeebs out.